What's going on, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on where in the world you're watching from. Guys, the 2000s were a wild time to grow up. I was born in 1998, and I spent the better part of my life amidst the trends and fashion and TV shows of the early 2000s and the late 2000s. With that decade in the past, we as a society have left behind so many valuable things that are so important to our nature and that contribute to who we are today. I've compiled a little list here of my favorite 2000s fashion things. So here we go, we're gonna just take a quick look at these. We had belly necklaces, side lace jeans, front lace jeans, laced shirts, anything that could have lace did have lace, fedoras, and large ties. With all these really sad things that we've lost, it really, you know, touches the heart. But I think the most important thing that we've lost since the early 2000s are the TV shows. Nothing on screen nowadays can compare to the sheer madness of the early 2000s and the late 2000s and the TV shows they've created. During this time period, my favorite show to watch with my friend was 1000 Ways to Die. After school in fourth grade, we'd go to his house, we'd get a big glass of milk, we'd sit there with some cookies, and we'd just chill out, and we would watch 1000 Ways to Die. Now, this show was aired between 2008 to 2012, so for 4 years, and the only reason it ended was because it had really bad ratings, and the workers went on strike. But man, this show is addicting, and man, did I love it. Today, we're gonna be specifically looking at Way to Die, number 126. So, without further ado, we're gonna dive on into this episode headfirst.
There's a reason why video games make more money than movies. They are as addictive as crack.
So already, we get a quick little glance at the perception, the 2000s perception of video games. They're comparing a simple video game, which a lot of people nowadays enjoy, to an illicit substance that literally ruins users' lives. I don't know about that.
Garth was a game junkie whose only reality was virtual.
I really like the way that they portray Garth in this sketch. What this sketch tells me is that it was written by some boomer that has absolutely never played video games before in their life. And this is like the classic gamer. This is what they think about when they think about gaming. Nowadays, I feel like gamers are more fit than ever, dude. Gaming and fitness have somehow intertwined, and we have these giga chads of gaming that are just like absolutely shredded to the gills and can outlift any basic gym rat. They're also godly at playing video games. It's crazy, dude.
He lived for online tournaments with dozens of like-minded geeks.
Holy shit, look how fast this dude's hands move. You're gonna tell me this guy doesn't have a girlfriend?
Attention, noobs and noobettes. I'm gonna knock all of you out.
The games can go on for days at a time.
Online tournaments for games work like this. You pick your game, you pick your category of game.
We got Pat, whose role is a video game historian. I don't think that's even a real job. I've done some research on this. I cannot find anywhere where there's a video game historian, but to be honest with you, I really like this Pat guy. He's got insane drip on the shirt. He probably pulls so much.
Say deathmatch or capture the flag. Then you either compete by yourself or with the team.
Going down, Lavendal.
Yeah, is that all you got, Garth?
An average gamer may only play maybe 10 to 15 hours a week. However, a hardcore gamer may play 30 hours or more a week.
Hold up. They're claiming that an average gamer plays 10 to 15 hours. That's like approximately 2 hours a day, every single day, 7 days a week. When I think of your average gamer, I think about a casual gamer that might hop on for like 30 or 40 minutes, play a couple rounds of COD or Fortnite or whatever, just to unwind after their day of work and go to bed. But you're telling me 10 to 15 hours a week? That's a part-time job. And then hardcore gamers are gaming 30 to 40 hours a week? That is a full-time job.
Garth didn't want to miss 1 second of the action.
Pizza delivery.
Yeah. Put it on my tab.
This guy is basically living every early 2000s middle schooler's dream right now.
He had a steady stream of junk food delivered. And for his bathroom needs, an empty bottle took care of number one, and a specially designed...
You see that splashback right there? He literally puts his piss bottle on the pizza box, and it splashes onto the pizza. Also, two, how does he distinguish between which bottle is the piss bottle and which bottle is not the piss bottle? When you're deep in the mindset of playing video games, you know, you don't really pay attention to what you're doing. I can imagine on more than one occasion, Garth has reached over, picked up the wrong bottle, picked up his piss bottle, and taken a swig off of it. And he probably didn't even notice. I would be willing to bet money that that happened.
Bucket seat took care of what came out the other end. This tournament had taken on the feeling of a death match. After 52 hours, Garth's bad diet and worse hygiene produced body sores, but he didn't care. He had eliminated all of his opponents. Everyone except Tina.
Noobzores.
Oh, why you keep running from me, you stupid girl?
Classic 2000s gamer moment. Imagine being a female and playing video games.
Oh, you don't like being beat by a girl?
If he could beat her, Garth would be the highest ranked player in the world. Somehow, Tina stayed cool as a cucumber, while Garth looked like a big zit about to burst. Finally, Tina took him down.
Suck it! Suck it! You just got pwned!
Oh, dude.
Garth was devastated. After 60 straight hours of non-stop gaming, Garth stood up and dropped, like someone had just pulled the plug on his avatar. Garth was a goner.
Can I get an F in the chat for Garth here? Garth died after 60 consecutive hours of gaming, shitting in his chair, and pissing in a bottle. Now we're gonna get a little quick wrap up if you guys are actually curious as to what happened to Garth. And I'm pretty sure that Garth is like the fake name for this character. Obviously, they're not going to disclose the real identity. Here's just a little backup on what actually happened medically.
Our video game player sat for such a long time and developed such massive clots in his veins and his legs that when he stood up, they broke free and floated up to his heart and to his lungs. And within a matter of a few seconds, there was enough blood that was coagulated in his lungs that he couldn't breathe. And his heart probably stopped within a few minutes after that. It caused him to die.
Garth ruined his health and sacrificed his life by living in a virtual fantasy world.
I'm gonna knock all of you out.
You just got pwned!
Courage, over girl!
Too bad his wake-up call was his own death. Game over, Garth.
So there you have it, guys. That is why you should never, ever play video games for 60 hours straight. It's obviously very dramatized. I'm sure that this has happened somewhere in the world at some point. It's hard to imagine that out of 8 billion people, this scenario has never happened. If you guys want to see more of these types of videos, definitely make sure to leave a like. Drop a comment down below. If you guys have seen the show, let me know. More so, if you guys have a specific way to die that you want me to cover, I'd be more than happy to cover it. Subscribe if you haven't already. Turn on post notifications so you never miss a video. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.